Hey, it's Nicole at the Pearl Review. How are you? If you're watching this video, maybe you're like me and you equate the life of the mind with the good life. However, maybe you're starting to feel increasingly at odds with your own society.
Hey, what you reading for? Well, looks like we got ourselves a reader.
Weavers of the intellectual freak flag, this book is for you. It's an intellectual and anti-intellectual history of the United States. If you're wondering how we got here,
I'm a very stable genius.
This book takes you from pre-revolutionary America to 1963. Now, a major point of this book is that anti-intellectualism is a recurring theme, but it is cyclical. It has its highs and lows, its peaks and valleys, and the author actually experienced that during his own time writing this. Inspired by the McCarthy trials and the prominent intellectual Adlai Stevenson's loss of the presidency to Dwight D. Eisenhower, a man who loved Western novels and openly made fun of eggheads, the author actually finished this book during the JFK administration. Kennedy being an author himself, and he routinely checked in with intellectuals during his own presidency. Now, this book might seem like a self-indulgent choice, and if not read carefully, it can become a total pity party. However, the author many times over reminds us that self-pity does not serve anyone. It doesn't serve you, it doesn't serve me. However, gaining historical context on one of the greatest problems of our current age does. Hofstadter does so by examining three of the core institutions in American life, namely the church, our education system, and the government. And he also reminds us that some of the greatest moments in American history were spearheaded by American intellectuals, namely the Founding Fathers during the Revolutionary War and the post-revolutionary period, Theodore Roosevelt's presidency during the Progressive Era, and the intellectual architects of the New Deal. What's interesting about this book is that it's really nuanced. You know, anti-intellectualism is never in a pure distilled form, which Hofstadter reminds us of. Oftentimes it's paired with some of our best core values, namely our egalitarian and democratic principles. And oftentimes, academia and intellectualism is vilified by being paired with elitism and with aristocracy. And that's namely how John Quincy Adams loses his incumbent candidacy to Andrew Jackson, being a populist demagogue, which I actually didn't even remember that one followed the other. And it seems like a major watershed moment in American history, if you think about it, because you have some of the Founding Fathers being, the great presidents of, early American history. And then Hofstadter goes into talking about the populist movement and its wreaking havoc, really, on American politics for, much of the 19th century. Hofstadter has a lot to say about education. He wrote about education for 10 years before even writing this book. And an interesting thing I learned about while reading this was the life adjustment reform period of the 40s and 50s. Namely, education becomes compulsory for all children in America under 16 years of age during the 40s and 50s. So basically, academic rigor becomes diluted because you have this huge population now that needs to be educated. And this life adjustment reform is rooted in the Progressive Era, and it focuses on the needs of the student. There is this switching over from academic excellence to this focus on making this person a working member of society, a member of democracy, but maybe not a highly intellectual one. So what's interesting about this is that it shows how intellectualism sometimes can be in conflict with some of our democratic principles. Namely, there is a conflict between academic accessibility and academic excellence. Now, this book is really interesting, but at times it can be as dry as a desert. But that doesn't mean that I don't recommend it so much. It is a really, really relevant read, and I recommend it to anyone who is considering reading it. It's highly informative and highly thought-provoking. So thanks so much for listening. If you have read it and you want to share your thoughts, please do so below. Take care. Bye.